everyone, welcome to my channel, Mrs. Homemaker. I come back to you with yet another useful video, this time around kitchen inventory, how to put a check on some of our key inventory, kitchen inventory item. And as we all know, lockdowns and pandemic have brought a huge change in the way we live our day-to-day life. While it is wise to save money in these times, it is even wiser to put a control on our expenditure. There are some expenditure which can be curbed and we can plug them, like extravagant expenditures like vacations or jewelries and stuff like that. There are certain expenditures which are an essential part of our day-to-day lives, which goes around our daily diet, the consumption of our daily food items. We cannot put a check around it. Milk has to be bought because there are kids and older people around the house to consume it. Curd is necessary, ghee is necessary, butter is necessary, buttermilk or yogurt. So I'm just talking about a small item around milk. So everything is necessary. We have to buy these things, and they form a major part of our expenditure. So why not make a change around how we deal with our expenditure related to them, in a way that not only we get these items without any bumps, but at the same time we are able to save a large part of our expenditure too. So today I will be discussing with you a very good methodology around how to extract butter. This method that I will be showing is a very easy method and can be used by both males and females and can be done easily. I have specially taken into account that I closely shoot this video so that you are able to clearly understand the textures and the stages of the process, and you are able to understand that what needs to be done at what stage, what kind of a texture needs to be there, and what is it that you need to do during those times and stuff like that. This method is derived after years of experience by me, which I have learned through so many talented women and of our families and neighbors and stuff like that, and from our maids and all. And I think this is the best method, and it would be very helpful to you. So please go through this complete video, because I would be sharing major tips and tricks in it for you, so that you can extract the best quantity of butter, apart from being very rich in quality. It would be very nutritious, and lot of quantity can be derived. Usually what I do is, from 1.5 liters of milk every day, I just pick the cream, I just extract the cream and keep it in the freezer. And by the end of the 7th day of the week, this ranges anywhere between 750 grams to 1 kg. And from this cream, I extract butter and ghees and stuff like that. Today I'll be discussing only on butter. So from 1 kg of cream, you would easily extract approximately 750 grams of delicious butter, which doesn't smell bad, and it's very delicious. It's more in quantity and it's very, very nutritious. And second is buttermilk, which would be thick and very yummy to consume. I hope you like the method. Please go and check the video.
Keep the cream outside freezer for 24 hours for it to defreeze. Once it defreezes, put a spoonful of curd and keep it outside for fermentation. Put it back in the cooling section of the fridge until it gets completely chilled. Now whisk the cream with a good whisker until the cream completely breaks. I'll be showing you some close-up slides throughout on purpose because I want you to see the texture of the cream. It's the texture by which you are able to make a right consistency of butter. Normally people don't land up making butter rightly, so this is one reason why I'm showing you closely. What happens is when you first whisk the cream, initially it will thicken. It has to be, you know, like a thick paste. Wait, I'll show you it's done. See, it's a thick paste. The cream is completely broken and it's become like with a thick consistency. You see, it has lost its pasty consistency and has become little more thicker. I'll show you the progression at this stage. You can see it's getting stuck around the blades and the whisker blades. So it's become thick. I'll show you with the spoon also. Now what we have to do is we again further need to whisk it till the time we start seeing a layer of liquid. Now this cluster that has formed of cream will further break down into two separate parts, liquid and solid. This is still solid and we can see little liquid coming out of, separating off from the solids. Can you see? I'll show it with the spoon. See, can you see that milky consistency? Now the liquid has started separating. Normally people think this is the stage to extract butter. No, this isn't. So here is a tip for you. Again, go and whisk the whole thing. Further, meanwhile, I'll take a bowl of chilled water filled with ice. We will use this bowl to secure extracted butter. As I mentioned earlier, because there's not much of liquid that we are seeing, we are again supposed to whisk this further until we see a good layer of liquid floating up, just like this. It's done now. Let me give you a closer view. Look how much of liquid has come, and it's completely, the fat is completely separated from the liquid. This liquid is buttermilk. Now that butter is formed, we need to churn this so that we can extract it without any difficulty. So we will whisk it one more until the fat get clustered into one ball, or you know, it starts coming or clustering together. It will start coming together. The butter has started clustering and it's leaving the blades. If you see that, the butter has completely got off the blade and liquid has separated. This is perfectly done butter. Now we need to separate this butter from the liquid. Bring all the butter on one side of the vessel with the help of the spoon, so that it would be easy for us to separate butter. This butter, we need to further squeeze it, and so that all the liquid or the buttermilk completely comes out of it. For that, the best method is to do with bare hands. Wash your hands properly. Take a thick ball of butter and squeeze it hard until all the liquid gets drained off. Form balls of butter. If you follow this methodology, the butter that you extract would be higher in quantity, tastier and full of nutrition. Because we had kept the cream overnight for 24 hours for fermentation, the butter extracted this way is very, very rich in lactobacillus, which are healthy bacteria and are very useful for our guts, thus making this butter rich in probiotics. I will now be taking this well squeezed ball of butter and putting it into the bowl of chilled water that we had taken earlier. We have now completely extracted our butter. The liquid remaining is buttermilk, and look how thick it is. After waiting for 5 minutes, we can separate these butter balls and keep it separate for consumption, or you can use it further for making ghee. Ensure to wash these butter balls nicely in chilled water so that they completely get rid of sourness. You will never be able to extract so much of butter with so much of nutritional value if you don't go by this methodology, where you need to be particular about stages and extra whisking. I hope you like the video, so kindly check in the like button and share your comments in the comment box. I would love to revert back to you.